Hey everybody, it's John. Welcome back to the shop. In this section, we're going to take this inch and a half aluminum rod and use it to start on the engine head. We'll also use this same material for the cylinder, which will follow the engine head here as we build it. As I said on the previous video, the head is not difficult to make, but it does have some rather complex drilling angles and so forth. Again, not difficult, but you will have to watch what you're doing. I hope you've had an opportunity since the last video to review the plans and maybe even go so far as to make yourself a little drawing. But nonetheless, by this time, I really encourage you, before you put any tooling to the aluminum, is to really in your mind go through the steps that you're going to need to be doing to make this head. We're going to go to the lathe. The first thing I've got to do is, now my lathe does not have a mandrel center or hole in the mandrel big enough for this to go through. If your lathe is inch and a half or bigger, you will not have to do what I'm going to do. But what I'm about to do, since mine will not go through the headstock, I'm going to chuck it up on one end and I'm going to use the steady rest on the other end and to do the machining on. I'm going to need to do that and just make a 9/16 piece that will go off. There's no other way to do that other than just slice it off and start with it that I know of. You might be able to drill all your holes and so forth and then come back and slice it off, but what I'm going to do is make the 9/16 slice, and from that point on I'll be working in the three jaw chuck. So right now, join me over here at the lathe as we get started on the Upshur engine head. What I'm going to do right here for the next few minutes is just put it in high speed a little bit. Here you see I'm installing the steady rest, because you're going to need this since, or at least I will need this since my headstock hole is not big enough to cover this. Now what you didn't see right here is when I initially set up the bar stock. You're going to need to indicate that as close as possible to the headstock itself. And what I've done here is already indicated as much as I can the trueness that this thing is running out towards the end of that steady rest. And you're going to see me tinkering just a little bit with it right here. But remember, I've already got it centered. The only thing I'm doing right now is just making sure that I have not messed with the setting too much. As you can imagine, you can get the indicator to run true, but your bar may still not be straight. There's plenty of videos out there on how to set that bar up if you need to use that, but if you've used a steady rest before, it's very easy to do. Here you just see me tinkering just a little bit, tightening up, and at all times making sure that the indicator does not move. And that's why I'm just doing it a little bit at a time, making the adjustments. And once again, turning and making sure that everything is tight. Now here it is, I'm tightening the screws all the way around the steady rest, and just doing that a little bit at a time, and once again, making sure that I'm indicating all the way along. And again, initially I set the indicator up near the headstock and got it running through there, then just slid the steady rest down. And here it is, I'm just dialing in the last little bit of it. Give it one more shake here, put some oil on it, make sure everything is running true, and the oil that I'm using is just regular oil. In a few minutes when I get to turning, I'm gonna put whey oil on it. I don't know if that does any good or not, but I just like the little thickness of the whey oil that's on it. One more time, give it a quick rotation, make sure everything is running smooth. Now we're ready to start turning. Initially, what I'm about to do here is just face the end off, putting the whey oil on it right now, and you want to keep that really well lubricated. Some steady rest, and you may have one also that has a ball bearing on it. If so, of course you don't need lubrication, but mine just has those little bronze wipes on it. Again, here it is, I'm just facing off. Now the cutting lubricant that I'm using is charcoal lighter fluid. I've read that somewhere years ago and I'm using that. Here I'm just taking a Mark-a-Lot to mark the end of it off to make sure that I've got everything pretty square, so I'll give it a quick slice off the end. Right now I'm getting ready to cut off the piece, and I'm just using a regular cutoff bar, and you probably will need to slow the lathe down as I've done here at that particular time. Now the cutoff is almost completely through, And just during this time, of course, you'll need to make sure that you've got plenty of lubricant. Again, I'm using charcoal lighter fluid. You can use WD-40, you can use A6, Alumitap, and so forth. Part's now been completely cut off, and that will be the slab of the head. Now, what I did also, you may have noticed, I put a little blue on the end of that. I've got a blue side, I'm gonna put a red side on it. Here I'm just checking the thickness and making sure I've got consistent thickness all the way around. You want that to be pretty close, and by close I mean within a thousandth or so. Opposites, this is the cutoff side here. This is the side that came off with the cutoff blade. So now I'm facing it to get it as flat as possible. I'm using some parallels in the jaw to get that right, and making sure everything is good and tied up against there. And here I'm just going to face that. I want a pretty good finish on it. I'm going to use the dial indicator to make sure everything is running true in the three jaw, and give it a quick twist and remove that. And here, as I said, I'm just facing the face because this is the side that's actually going to be down or attached to the cylinder. It's also where all the valves will be, and this will be where the layout will be done from. Again, I'm just checking the thickness. I'm looking for 9/16 all the way around, and I'm just using that here, zeroing out my caliper, and I hit it right on the button right there, making sure everything is smooth. And here I'm just chamfering the edge with a little file. You don't need much chamfer on it because it's going to go on the head. Taking it out, now I've got the blue side. That's going to be the top side. And then I'm putting everything back in. And what I'm going to be doing right here is center punching it. Now, it didn't hurt anything to take that thing out. All I'm doing right here is just putting a 7/16 circle in it. I'm going to use a little center drill. Now, that center drill, all you want to do here is just make the smallest of pips on it. You don't want to make a big hole. You're not drilling a hole. What you're going to do here is just making a place to put one leg of your caliper in. You're setting your caliper, you want a 7/16 diameter, so you're going to make it half of 7/16 as your radius, and then turn it around. And what you're doing here is drawing your 7/16 diameter. Here I'm just double checking it with a scale, making sure I've got 7/16. Remember, I've got the one red side and I've got the one blue side. Okay, I'm back at the bench and we're getting ready to do the layout of all the holes that we have. Now, as I said, this is not a difficult operation is this head, but it is a little bit complex. Now, what I do, especially for some of these more complex parts, is go through my head and see the operations that I'm going to be doing. And essentially, here's what I'll be doing. I'm going to be doing the center diameter, which I've already done that. And that's this right here, 7/16 is what you'll need. And that's the purpose of that little pip that you saw me do with the tailstock and the center drill. That's not deep, it's just enough to hold one leg of your caliper. So I've drawn that circle 7/16. Now the next thing I need to do is I need to find my center diameter, which I'm just going to draw a line across that with my scale, with my ruler here in a minute. Next thing is I'm going to go 30 degree angle at the right side, a 45 degree angle from center on the left side. Then I'm going to lay out the valves. I'm going to lay out the spark plug. That's all the layout that I'm going to do here, are those things there, is the valves and the spark plug. When I get through, and this will be on the next video, I'm going to go to the milling machine, and then I'm going to lay out and drill the number 29 two times. Now, the number 29 two times are going to be these two right here, and that's going to be for the hold downs. Then I'm going to lay out and drill for the rocker arm. Now, that's the one right here that is the rocker arm is, I don't have the rocker, yeah, here's the rocker arm right here. The rocker arm is a through hole, that's also number 29, and I do that, so I lay out and drill for these two holes, lay out for the rocker arm, then locate and drill the 3/16 for the two valves, that's these two valves, they'll be 3/16, and that's going to be all the holes that'll be drilled from this way. Everything is through except for this one right here, which is the spark plug hole, and that's a partial hole. But I'll do all that at the milling machine. And then we'll have to come back and we'll have to meet some of these holes drilling in from the side. So I'm going to go ahead and get started. The tools that I'm going to be using, and you can use just whatever you've got, but I'm going to start with the center finder here and go ahead and draw down here on my center finder. And well, wasn't good. So go ahead, now I've got that marked. That's my center. So on that, I've got to come down on my 7/16 and I'm just going to make a little pip is all I'm going to do. And where I have it is right here, and that's where one of my valves goes. So I'm intersecting that center line and that 7/16. Just come in just a little bit, double check it. Remember, a little tap, because you can move it if it's not just right. And that's right on the money. So now I've got that one done. Now the next thing was go 30 degrees to the right. And so I go 30 degrees to the right side. Well, I need to get my horizontal line. So let me come in and get the horizontal line next. All right, here's how I get the horizontal, or a 90 degree angle from this line right here. There's a lot of other ways to do this, but this is the way that I'm going to do it. I find the distance from the center. I've just got my center in that little punch right down there. So I bring this down till it fits on top of there. Then I come over here and make sure that line is equal, and it is. So now I can come down with that line. So that's, so now I need to go over 30 degrees. That's my 30 degree hole. Then come over for my 45 degrees. And that's going to be 45 degree hole. So go ahead and get that punched. That one looks good. Well, I just did that backwards. See, you mess up, you just go back. I mark it out. That doesn't hurt anything. I've got to come down and move that hole down here. That's the purpose of making little light pip parts, pip marks. That's not going to hurt anything. Then just make that one. So now I've got these three holes marked here. I've got this hole pricked there. I've got this one pricked up here, and I've got that one pricked over there. So this right here is going to be 40, 30, 45, and 90 degrees. All right, so that's all that I'm going to be doing on the first part. I've got my center diameter, 30 degrees to the right, 45 degrees to the left, marked my lines. So I've laid out my two valves and laid out for my spark plug. These holes will go all the way through. These two will here, they'll be ring 3/16. This one right here is only gonna go partially way through to pick up where the spark plug comes in. Well, I'm gonna leave it for there for right now. And that's the layout. And the next step is we're gonna go to the milling machine and start doing some drilling operations and go in from the side and do some of those layouts also. So join us on the next section. Thank you for watching. Really appreciate all the comments. Leave them down below. If you haven't subscribed, consider doing so. Until next time, this is John from one side of a two-car garage here in the great state of Texas. We'll see you back in the shop.